हेलो, गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन। आई होप यू ऑल आर गुड एंड योर प्रिपरेशन इज गोइंग इन फैंटास्टिक मैनर। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट लेक्चर नंबर 2 ऑफ डीसी-डीसी कन्वर्टर। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दिस सेशन, आई वांट टू रिकैप द प्रीवियस लेक्चर दैट यू हैव कवर्ड। व्हाट इज आइडियल स्विच, बिकॉज वी आर गोइंग टू कंसिडर ऑल द स्विचेस इन आई मीन थ्रू आउट द एनालिसिस ऑफ डीसी-डीसी कन्वर्टर, स्विच एज एन आइडियल स्विच। सेकेंड थिंग, वोल्टेज टाइम क्राइटेरिया। For inductor, we will assume that input voltage and output voltage is ideally constant, although in practical condition it is not so. But the inductor and capacitor is working its best, so output voltage is pure DC. So voltage time criteria for inductor and current time criteria for capacitor. This was homework. I hope you have tried in the same way we discussed this criteria, voltage time criteria for inductor. So now we are ready to jump on DC-DC converter. DC-DC converter, if you see, ideally classified, broadly ideally classified into two categories. First one is linear, and second one is switched mode. Switched mode converters, which we are going to study in this course, belongs to this category, switched mode, right? So all this buck, बक बूस्ट एंड बूस्ट, ठीक है, आप सेकेंड भी बूस्ट लिख देना, राइट। दिस कन्वर्टर्स कम्स इन द कैटेगरी ऑफ स्विच्ड मोड। लीनियर कन्वर्टर वॉज देयर बिफोर स्विच्ड मोड डीसी-डीसी कन्वर्टर्स। लीनियर मीन्स दैट इट इज मेड अप ऑफ लीनियर डिवाइसेस लाइक RLC ओनली। एंड सेकेंड थिंग, आपने नाम इसका सुना होगा आई थिंक डेली लाइफ में। बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर में बता दूंगा आपको, जैसे आपको एक इनपुट वोल्टेज है, इसको जैसे 10 वोल्ट है, आपको इसको 2 वोल्ट में कन्वर्ट करना है। ये लोड है आपका, इसको 2 वोल्ट में कन्वर्ट, यू वांट टू कन्वर्ट दिस 10 वोल्ट इनटू 2 वोल्ट। यू कनेक्ट ए रेजिस्टेंस इन सीरीज विद दिस इनपुट एंड आउटपुट, राइट, RSE। So this comes in the category of linear converter. Then advancement happened in this linear conversion, but philosophy was that only that additional voltage will be dropped across a resistance in series or parallel. So the advanced version of this is a zener based regulator. अपने अपने कोर्स में कभी पढ़ा भी होगा जीनर एज ए वोल्टेज रेगुलेटर एंड ऑल। सो द अल्टीमेट प्रॉब्लम विद दिस लीनियर टाइप ऑफ डीसी-डीसी कन्वर्टर वाज इफिशिएंसी। efficiency. Efficiency was very low. If conversion ratio is high, then if efficiency is low, then definitely loss is higher. If loss is higher, then heat will be higher, heat generated. And if heat is there, then definitely the power rating of the device is going to be low. So for linear DC-DC converter, the efficiency was very poor, losses were very high, definitely heat will be generated higher, then power rating of the overall system cannot be high. So all these issues are addressed by switched mode type devices. So here you can blindly say that efficiency is higher. Losses are low. So definitely heat will be low and power rating of devices, overall devices higher, can be higher. So this is the classification. So now we can move to switched mode power conversion. So I thought you should know, that's why I discussed. So the very first converter in DC-DC conversion is buck converter. So buck DC-DC converter, this type of DC-DC converter is used to reduce the input voltage. So if you want to convert 10 volt into 5 volt or 4 volt, you will choose, if you want to choose a switched mode DC-DC converter, then you will have to go for buck converter, right? The schematic circuit of buck converter is like this. I will say circuit diagram. It is creating problem. Circuit diagram is this. This is V input, this is V output, this is switch, this is diode, this is inductor, this is capacitor, and this is load resistance. So this circuit belongs to buck conversion. Before going for analysis, I want to tell you one thing, that for analysis purpose, your motive should be to draw वोल्टेज अक्रॉस इंडक्टर ऑलवेज, राइट? कोई भी सर्किट हो, डीसी डीसी कन्वर्टर का, किसी भी टाइप का कन्वर्टर हो, कुछ नई टोपोलॉजी हो, यू विल ऑलवेज ट्राई टू ड्रॉ वोल्टेज अक्रॉस इंडक्टर इन बोथ कंडीशन. व्हाट आर दोज कंडीशंस? व्हेन स्विच इज ऑन एंड व्हेन स्विच इज ऑफ. राइट? सो यू सी द सर्किट. I will ask you what will be the voltage across inductor in both condition, right? Second thing, assume, as I told you, that input voltage and output voltage are perfectly DC. There is nothing variation, right, for analysis purpose. So when switch is on, case one. Switch is on. What do you think about circuit? Switch is on. I told switch is on means perfectly short circuit. Here was diode, here was inductor, capacitor, load. See, this positive negative terminal of input voltage will reverse bias this diode, so this diode will be disconnected. It is not in the picture and circuit is similar like this. What is the voltage across inductor? Voltage across inductor is Vin minus, I will write, हो सकता मेरी वहां पर picture आ रही हो, so I will write in lower portion. VL is equal to Vin minus V naught. Okay, what inductor will do if I am taking this direction as a positive direction, here plus, here minus, this is the positive direction, then inductor will charging. अब आपको पता है चार्जिंग मीन्स इंडक्टर चार्ज किस तरीके से होता है, इन द फॉर्म ऑफ करंट. इट स्टोर्स एनर्जी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ करंट, सो करंट विल बी इंक्रीजिंग थ्रू द इंडक्टर, राइट? व्हेन स्विच इज ऑफ, व्हेन स्विच इज ऑफ, दिस सर्किट बिकम this is inductor, now this is open circuit, here was inductor, here was capacitor and load, and there was one diode here which was not conducting when this was on because it was reverse biased by input supply. Now inductor was having some current, right, because it was charging. And when you stop the, conduction from switch, where this energy will go? It will force this diode to conduct so that current can discharge in this way. So higher voltage will develop across, will be observed across this diode, and here minus and here plus. In this way, voltage of inductor will be. So this, because inductor charge जिस direction में होता है उसके जस्ट अपोजिट डायरेक्शन में डिस्चार्ज होता है. मीन्स वैन इंडक्टर इज चार्जिंग, इफ पोलरिटी इज प्लस माइनस, देन वैन इट विल बी डिस्चार्जिंग पोलरिटी विल बी माइनस प्लस, जस्ट रिवर्स. दिस इज नॉट इन द केस ऑफ कैपेसिटर. सो इट विल कम इन द पिक्चर. एंड वैन डायोड इज इन कंडक्शन इट विल बी परफेक्टली शॉर्ट सर्किट. नाउ वी हैव एज्यूम दैट पोलरिटी वॉज हियर प्लस हियर माइनस. इफ यू सी what is the voltage across inductor, so voltage across inductor is minus V naught. Agree? And in this case inductor is discharging, right? Okay, now how it will charge and discharge, we know that VL is equal to L di by dt. So if particular voltage is there across inductor, then how current will be behaving with time, that nature can be derived from this equation in charging as well as in discharging. If you plot the curve waveforms, so you help me in drawing. Okay, later if needed we will draw it. So switch in this way that it is on and then off. This is switch, so this is T on, this is T off, and this total time is capital T, and this sequence is repeated, that's why this 1 upon T is known as switching frequency. Right, and T is equal to T on plus T off. Okay. If you draw the voltage across inductor, this is VL. So when switch was on, VL was V in minus V naught. When switch was off, this voltage was minus V naught. In case of when switch is on, this current through the inductor will be current, inductor is charging, So current will be increasing. And the discharging current will be decreasing. Again it will be increasing and decreasing. Why this linear line is there? What is the slope of this line? We will see. If conductor is in is not in saturation, it means the point up to which it is charging, then it will discharge to a certain point. Again, when it will charge, it will reach to that point only. Then it will discharge to back to that point. It means maximum point and minimum point is fixed, right? And current is not increasing like anything, because ultimately after a certain amount of flux or flux density, inductor get saturated. So saturation is not there. If saturation is not there, then from voltage time criteria, you have studied in the last lecture, this area is going to be equal to this area. So what is this? So V in minus V naught into T on is equals to V naught into T off. If you rearrange this mathematical equation, then V in T on is equal to V naught T, and V naught is equal to V in T on upon T. This T on upon T is known as duty ratio, D, denoted by D. You tell me, what is, what can be the maximum value of T on? Obviously T, not more than that. So, and what can be minimum value? It is 0. So D ki value jo hai, D lies from 0 to 1. And you can see that when from this output equation, 1 minute, V naught is equal to V in into D. So when D is 0, V naught is 0. When D is 1, V naught is equal to V in. So output voltage can be controlled from 0 to in between 0 to input supply input voltage, right? So this is the output voltage expression in case of buck converter. How this charging of inductor or discharging of inductor is happening? What is the expression? So I am taking the first condition, and you try by your own in at your home, right, after this lecture. So in on condition, on condition means when switch is on, right, this VL is going to be V in minus V naught. So the current equation can be written as L di by dt can be written as V in minus V naught. It means di by dt is equal to V in minus V naught upon L. So if someone asks you that what is the slope of this line, definitely it is going to be V in minus V naught upon L, right? Since this switch is turning on, turning off, turning on, turning off at a certain frequency. So in the very starting, when inductor is purely discharged, it will be starting from zero. The current will be starting from zero in the very starting. It will be charging, then it will be discharging. In the discharging time, it may come to zero, it may not come to zero. Again it is charging and it is discharging, right? So generally in book they consider this current starting from a particular value, not from zero, right? Not from zero. But in the very starting of this operation, it would have started from zero only, right? So suppose the minimum value of inductor current is I min and maximum value, when it will be there, maximum value at the end of T on, at the end of T on, the maximum value is going to be I max. Suppose, so it means I am drawing here, it is charging, it is discharging, it is charging, it is discharging in this way. So this point is I min, this is I max. What is the equation of this line? I am trying to drive it, and you will do at your home for this line. So if you take the integration of this equation, so di integration, this is integration of v in minus v naught upon l dt, integration 0 से t. ये करंट कहाँ से कहाँ जा रही होगी? कहीं भी आप किसी इस पॉइंट पे अगर आप देख रहे हैं, इन बिटवीन द दिस लाइन यहाँ पे, तो ये करंट स्टार्ट कहाँ से हुई? आई मिन से. और कहाँ तक गई? किसी वैल्यू आई तक गई. सो द इक्वेशन ऑफ द लाइन इज आई माइनस I min is equal to V in minus V naught upon L into T, right? So this is the equation of the line. So I is equal to V in minus V naught upon L T plus I min. अगर मुझे I max निकालना है तो मैं T की वैल्यू क्या रखूं? I hope आपको पता चल गया. So this I max is equal to, when you put T is equal to T on, I becomes I max. So this is V in minus V naught upon L into T on plus I min. मैं ये क्यों कर रहा हूं मैं आपको बताता हूं. सो अब आपको ये पता चल गया कि I min की वैल्यू एक्चुअली I min या I max की वैल्यू इनपुट वोल्टेज और टाइम और इंडक्टर, इन तीन चीजों पे डिपेंड कर रही है. डिजाइन ऑफ इंडक्टर, अगर कोई आप बक कन्वर्टर बना रहे हैं तो ऐसा तो है नहीं कि आप जस्ट आंख बंद करके जो भी आपके गांव में जिस तरीके से सिलेक्ट करते हैं उस तरीके से सिलेक्ट कर लिया। यू हैव टू डू प्रॉपर कैलकुलेशन। सो व्हेन यू डिजाइन बक कन्वर्टर दे विल गिव यू सम पावर रेटिंग, दैट डिजाइन फॉर दिस मच वाट एंड किलोवाट व्हाटएवर इट इज, they will give you switching frequency also, that they will give you percentage ripple in current and percentage ripple in voltage. I will tell you what is this and then will give you conversion ratio also, voltage conversion ratio, that this voltage is going to be converted into this voltage using that converter which is to be designed, right? So what is the concept of ripple? Actually you are studying DC-DC converter, so all the quantities belonging to DC-DC converter should be pure DC, but it is not so because due to switching inductor is charging and discharging. So if you see current through inductor IL, sorry, it is not pure DC, rather it is something like this. So the difference between maximum value and minimum value, this is known as ripple current, delta I. What should be the ideal value of ripple current? DC बोलता है कि हमारे there is no need of this variableness, right? So ideally it should be very minimum, very low. So they give you that this much ripple current is needed. Percentage ripple means with the respect of output current. So this is needed. Now you design inductor and capacitor. So if you know that formula which we have recently discussed, that I max is equal to I min plus V in minus V naught upon L into T on. You can find this delta I. So delta I becomes V in minus V naught upon L into T on. So L can be derived from this. So this is V in minus V naught upon L. This is T on upon delta I. So if input voltage is given, output voltage is given. Sorry, this inductor will not be there. So if input voltage, output voltage is given, so from input and output voltage switching frequency is given. So switching frequency means capital T is given. From this input and output you can define, you can calculate for duty ratio. With the help of duty ratio you can find out T on and in that way you can find inductor value, right? So inductor value can be designed. If you rearrange this equation, then it can also be written as in this way, that V in minus D V in upon delta I, and you do one modification, T on, you multiply with T and divide by T. So this T on upon T becomes again D. So this L becomes V in, aap andar se common le lo. So it is 1 minus D upon delta I. T on upon T is D, and T can be written as 1 upon Fs. So this is also 1 upon Fs. So this is the expression of inductor again. Was this much confidence can be achieved from you if you will practice it, right? So if percentage ripple is there, input voltage is given, output voltage is given, from there you can calculate D, right? And switching frequency is given, you can design the inductor. Agar is expression se aap dekhe, then for the same amount of ripple, size of inductor can be reduced if you increase the switching frequency. आपने देखा भी होगा, स्विचिंग फ्रीक्वेंसी, अगर आप फ्रीक्वेंसी बढ़ाते हैं तो साइज ऑफ इंडक्टर कम होता है. दूसरा, इफ रिपल करंट इज फिक्स्ड, इनपुट वोल्टेज इज फिक्स्ड, स्विचिंग फ्रीक्वेंसी इज फिक्स्ड, देन रिपल विल बी मैक्सिमम. नॉट, इंडक्टर इज फिक्स्ड, इनपुट वोल्टेज इज फिक्स्ड, आई एम रिपीटिंग, इंडक्टर इज फिक्स्ड, इनपुट वोल्टेज इज फिक्स्ड, स्विचिंग फ्रीक्वेंसी इज फिक्स्ड, देन रिपल करेंट विल बी मैक्सिमम एट डी इज इक्वल टू क्वेश्चन मार्क, कमेंट में लिख देना. सो इन दिस वे यू विल डिजाइन द इंडक्टर, राइट? नेक्स्ट, डिजाइन ऑफ कैपेसिटर. For what purpose capacitor was used? To stabilize the output voltage. Larger the inductance capacitance, stability will be more, output voltage will be pure DC. We have assumed also in the starting that input and output voltage are perfectly DC. So but in practical world we have to design capacitor. So if you see the capacitor circuit, here is inductor, here is capacitor, and this is load. आप बी डबल ई से पढ़ रहे हैं, जब बेसिक इलेक्ट्रिकल कोर्स पढ़ा था, दैट कैपेसिटर ब्लॉक डीसी कंपोनेंट एंड इट एक्सेप्ट एसी कंपोनेंट, राइट? इफ यू सी आईएल, आईएल इज नॉट प्योर डीसी, इट इज इंक्रीजिंग डिक्रीजिंग. सो इट कैन बी द इंडक्टर करेंट इज हैविंग टू पोर्शंस. First one is pure DC and pure AC. अब वो pure DC क्या है? तो यहां पे जो जाएगा वो जाएगा ILAC, मैंने AC का सिंबल ऊपर बना दिया, और यहां पे जाएगा ILDC, एवरेज वैल्यू. So if you see the waveform of inductor current, then only you will be able to see that which current is flowing through the capacitor. If you see this value is having two components, first one this average value. Average value is nothing but DC value. And then this is the AC content in IL, right? This is IL is AC and this is DC value IL is. If your inductor current is not touching to 0 point, then if you derive the expression for IL bar average value, you will get 1/2 I max plus I min. You verify it, right? So this AC component of inductor current is going through capacitor. If capacitor will interact with current which is varying with time, definitely it will affect the voltage of the capacitor, because I is equal to C dVc by dt, right? So if current is there, voltage of capacitor will change. So if you see the fundamental equation governing capacitance, Q is equal to CV. So delta Q is equal to C delta V. Change in the charge will result in change in the capacitor voltage DVC, delta VC. What is change in charge? What is charge? Charge is nothing but the area under current and time curve, because Q is I is equal to dQ by dt. I is equal to dQ by dt, and so dQ is I dt. So this is nothing but Q is equal to integration of I dt, so area under curve. So what is the net change in charge? This is the net change in charge. What is this amount? This amount is nothing but area of this triangle. So what is this time? This is T/2. What is this height? This is delta I/2, because delta I is this and this. This is delta I, so delta I/2. So what is delta Q? Delta Q is equal to 1/2 into T/2 into delta I/2. So this is 1/8 T delta I. Delta Q is nothing but C delta V. C delta V is 1/8 T delta I. So C can be designed in this way, 1/8 T delta I upon delta V. If you again do some mathematical modifications, then it is delta I upon 8 fs. Fs means switching frequency, this is 1/T delta V. So you can design the capacitor also. So far we have discussed what is buck converter, what is the circuit diagram, what is the output voltage and input voltage governing equation, and how you will design inductor and capacitor of this buck converter. If you are having time, if you are final year student, you are not having much time. If you are third year student and second year student, you try to simulate it. Take a particular power, take a particular frequency, then design for inductor and capacitor, and then simulate it. It must verify your design, right? Simulation of the system must justify your design. Second thing, many times they ask that what is the current across the diode, right? What is the current across the diode? What is the current through the switch? What is the current through the inductor? What is the current through the capacitor? What is the current through load? So you can, I hope you are in that condition that you can find it. So if you see, suppose this is the inductor current, what is the current through diode? So when diode is there, when switch is off, right? So charging should not be there. So this portion only, this portion is through diode. So in this way, try to think, right? So I hope all these things are clear. You have no doubts. If you are having any doubts, you post it in your Telegram channel. I will address that issue. Thank you very much. Take care.